I'll give you an update on the build. Where am I at? I managed to get glued in. It's all set. It's in there solid. I'd still remove it if I had to. Did the input wires. Glued that only because I didn't want them to break loose, which I've already done once. They're not going to break again. Did the connectors on the back. Drilled the holes. I had to isolate the positives because the negatives were touching the case as well as positives. So I had to make sure they were not grounding out, but they're not. Some things I'm still going to do is I'm going to take the plastic off the caps, wrap those in copper. I still got to make a Humpty for that, obviously. I've been going over the wiring for the power supply, and there's probably maybe three or four wires only that I really need. That's for the high voltage section. The rest is low voltage. I'll have to go through that. Actually, what I think I'm going to do, if I'll show you here. I'm going to end up using these, but there's a higher end, like there's a higher end ones that I've seen on Amazon. They're aviation plugs, but I've seen ones that can take a little bit more amps. I think one of these, one big one in the back, will pretty much do it. That's all you really need. It's got four. If I need two of them, I need two of them. I can mark them so I don't mix them up and blow the amp up. But I think these would work pretty good. Just put this in the back. This plugs into it. So I'll have to order those up. What else? The fan. Probably today I've spent about an hour poking around off the ground trying to find anything that would be low enough to power that fan, and there's nothing. All I got to work with is 65 volts, 90 volts, 35. Obviously the rectifiers or the regulators are all blown because I already figured out what happened. Last time I serviced this unit, I unplugged this. This white line here has to be lined up with the white notch, obviously, on the board. Because one side's high side and one side's low side. And I mix them up. So basically, the 60 or 85 volts that goes into these main caps here went right to the regulator. And that's why everything went poof. So I was the one that blew it up. At least if I did it, I'll own up to it, right? So, oh well, it is what it is. What I should have done is I should have taken a marker and just marked it for reference, because you really can't see that white line too well. And I was in a hurry, I just plugged it in, didn't really think. And as you can see, because of a stupid design, you can reverse them. So, yeah, that's what blew it up. That's why there's no regulators working right now. So, yeah, what I'm probably going to do for the fan is I'm going to see if I can find a 60 or a 30 volt DC-DC inverter. I'll glue it here and wire it up, and then we'll run the fans off of that, and I can adjust the pot to adjust the speed of the fan. And then we're going to work on housing that, but I would like to use it without just leave that bare on the floor like that for now, just so at least I can use it. But it's coming along, and it is working, so I can show you, make sure everything is plugged in properly. There we go. I still haven't put a switch on the relay yet, which I will. But right now, as it stands, you could use it. So that's cool. When the parts come in and I start ripping this apart, I'll bring it back and we'll continue on the build. Right now, I'm just giving a chance for this shoe goo to set. If I have to pull this out, I still can, but this is pretty much where it's going to sit. If I blow the one module, I'll just wired up to the other one. It's no biggie. Later, guys.